Hello and welcome. Today we're going to take a closer look at the initial configuration of the Tabs3 billing software. After you install the software and log in for the first time, customization must be saved before you can use the software. Many of the settings in this window are already configured for the most common use case. However, let's take a few minutes to go over the different sections so you know what's here in case you want to change a few things. The key type and decimal places on the main tab are two of the more important fields. These fields determine the client numbering format for your firm. Client numbers can be numeric, alpha, or a combination of alpha and numeric, and they're collectively referred to as client IDs. The numeric key type allows you to take full advantage of valuable Tabs3 features, such as having Tabs3 automatically assign new client IDs and matters for those clients. When using a mixed key type, Tabs3 can automatically assign the next available matter for a client, but not the next available client ID. When using an alpha key type, all client IDs and matters for those clients must be manually assigned. Regardless of what key type you choose, you will be able to find clients by either their client ID or their name. And if you're not sure which key type to use, we recommend using a numeric key type. Other notable options on this tab include determining the first month of your firm's reporting year, verification list options, and email statements method. The Other Systems tab is where you can enable integration with other programs, including Tabs3 General Ledger and Trust Accounting. Additional options are provided for how trust information is displayed on Tabs3 billing statements. The Options tab is split up into four main areas: aging periods, statement numbering, timer options, and client funds. These options provide more freedom to control how information is calculated on reports, as well as basic timer and client funds functionality. The statement numbering is one of the fields that would be good to configure now. By default, this is set to firm level, meaning that statements will use one series of numbers for the entire firm. This allows you to enter a payment based on just the statement number. If your firm would like each client to have their own series of statement numbers beginning with 1, you can change this field to client level. The Rate tab provides the option to define various rates for sales tax associated with fees and costs, as well as if and how finance charges are assessed. If you plan to assess a finance charge to any of your clients, the Assess Finance Charge option must be selected to globally enable the ability to use it. You can still choose which matters will be charged at the matter level, but this option turns on the capability to do so. The Client Defaults tab provides several options that will be applied to new clients. These defaults can be changed at any time and will not affect clients already in Tabs3. Some of the more notable defaults are the method to apply payments, statement delivery method, and fund application. The Merchant Services tab allows you to enable credit card processing in Tabs3 and to define merchant accounts for credit card processing. Credit cards can optionally be enabled for payments, client funds, or both. Once you've selected your options, click Save or press Ctrl S to store your customization settings. Closing this window will then allow you to start using the Tabs3 billing software. For more information about customization, you can access help topics by selecting the question mark icon in the toolbar or by pressing F1 on your keyboard. Thanks for watching. See you next time.